wandering gypsies, a levitating young woman, a baby born with a pig's tail. Gabriel Garcia Marquez's Cien Años de Soledad, 100 Years of Solitude, is a Latin American novel filled with lush characters, civil war, and romances. The magical realism genre is greatly depicted in Marquez's work, or as Bertolossi states, the oxymoronic combination of magic and realism charges the term with seductive potency. In the novel, we follow the rise and fall of the Buendia family in a span of 7 generations. Although it is a complicated read, it is rewarding in the sense that we not only follow a fictional tale, but also mirrors Colombia's actual history and the author's personal experiences. Marquez paints magical characters and events in his story so beautifully that the only things that remain extraordinary are normal events. The setting, the fictional town of Macondo. As you go about the fortunes and misfortunes of the Buendia family, we also see changes in their founded town of Macondo. It all started with a dream, a vision of Jose Arcadio Buendia. He forms the town, and at the beginning, Macondo is a place of isolation. Apart from the visits of rag gypsies, there's no further connection to the outside world. At that time, Macondo was a village of 20 adobe houses built on the bank of a river of clear water that ran along a bed of polished stones, which were white and enormous like prehistoric eggs. The world was so recent that many things lacked names, and in order to indicate them, it was necessary to point. The omniscient narrator emphasizes how Macondo cannot stand on its own. Thus, we follow its relation to the plot of the story. The town is gradually introduced to the outside world. From then on, we learn how subjective reality, one of the themes in a novel, creates unity and conflict, producing byproducts such as friendship, love, civil wars, and death. The words that best describe Macondo is that it is a town of mirrors, as it is in the story, for it was foreseen that the city of mirrors or mirages would be wiped out by the wind and exiled from the memory of men. The place serves as a metaphor to the life of the Buendias. We slowly see through the illusion of a perfect life, supporting the common phrase, "Not all that glitters is gold." Being mirrors, we can also see how the setting reflects the lives of its inhabitants in many generations. Macondo, subjected to many conflicts, shifts away from the utopian town it was and loses its color. The name Macondo is taken from the Bantu word meaning banana. In the real events of Colombian history, bananas play a rather dreadful part linked to the death of many. The Banana Massacre in 1928 becomes an inspiration to one of the events in Macondo, when a fruit company based in the U.S. grows a banana plantation near the town, it kills thousands of workers who went on strike. Fragile are mirrors that in the end, as Melquiades the Gypsy foretold, Macondo and the Buendias become no more than shattered fragments powdered by the hurricanes of life. The story ends to quote, "Because races condemned to 100 years of solitude did not have a second opportunity on Earth." Although the novel ends with tragic deaths and loss of culture, Macondo brought to ruins brings a lesson to the readers of how our opinions and actions shape the world around us. The tragedy of Macondo is a reminder from Marquez to all of us that the effects of war are devastating. We should decline to accept the end of humanity. We should use knowledge for the greater good. The past, the present, and the future are inseparable things. We must reflect upon our history to know what is better for the next generations to come. As Gabriel Garcia Marquez said, in contrast to the ending of his book, in his Nobel Prize speech, "Faced with this awesome reality that must have seemed a mere utopia through all of human time, we, the inventors of tales, will believe anything, feel entitled to believe that it is not yet too late to engage in the creation of the opposite utopia, a new and sweeping utopia of life where no one will be able to decide for others how they die, where love will prove true and happiness be possible, and where the races condemned to 100 years of solitude will have, at last and forever, a second opportunity on Earth.
Dos oruguitas enamoradas pasan sus